Hey Astro Kids, and welcome back. If you like this, feel free to leave a like as well as a comment. If you are new to this channel, don't forget to hit the subscribe button as well as the notification bell. So today we're going to be talking about the North Node entering into Gemini, South Node entering into Sagittarius, which we will see on May 5th, 2020. So this is coming up very shortly here, where the nodes will shift positions. So major event here, and if you are not familiar with the nodes go back to Vedic sidereal astrology with Rahu and Ketu, which is the dragon, right? So we're not going to get into the whole story of Rahu and Ketu, but know that Rahu is the head of the dragon. Ketu is the headless body of the dragon. And so with this, we are talking about karma. And so Ketu, the headless body of the dragon, is symbolized as this endless pit, right? As much stuff as we can stuff into it. It doesn't fulfill us, it doesn't satisfy us, it doesn't do anything to help us grow or learn or gain anything. So that would be the South Node, Ketu, which is this lunar node that is dealing with karmic debt, that is dealing with these reoccurring patterns, these behaviors that we continue to repeat over and over again that do not help us learn, that do not fulfill us, that do not satisfy us in any way. And the head of the dragon, Rahu, is where we gain this new experience through the North Node. This is where we are destined to learn new lessons and have new experiences. And so this would be your karmic destiny. And so with these nodes, this is telling a story about what we need to let go of, what we need to release in our lives in order to pay off this karmic debt, and also where we need to head to gain new knowledge, new experiences to help us grow, to help us learn, to help us become better in our lives. So there's two parts to the nodes. And so what you're going to see here is as the North Node shifts into Gemini, the South Node will shift into Sagittarius. It's two parts, and they will always be in polar opposites with one another. And so we're leaving behind this axis here that is dealing with this North Node in Cancer, South Node in Capricorn, where the lesson has been about leaving behind these old systems, these old structures, these old traditional views and behaviors from the past, and coming into this space of connection and true family and true emotional fulfillment. And now as we come into this new nodal axis, we're seeing this shift here where the whole karmic story, the whole karmic lesson of what we need to release and what we need to overcome shifts into this new space. And this is a very powerful space that we are shifting into here, as the North Node is exalted in Gemini and the South Node is exalted in Sagittarius. And so these are coming into very, very dignified positions here, where these are major karmic stories and lessons that we need to face and overcome. And so as Rahu, the North Node, comes into Gemini here, we see this lesson that is dealing with communication, that is dealing with your thought process, that is dealing with the knowledge, the facts, the information, that is dealing with your familiar surroundings, right? And South Node, Ketu, in Sagittarius, dealing with belief systems, dealing with long-distance travel, dealing with higher faith and knowledge, right? And so there is something big about this shift here that is having us face the truth, that is having us face the facts of the universe as we're coming into this space. No longer are we able to create these old stories and old belief systems about what is really going on here in the universe. Right, with the North Node in Gemini, the information, the facts are coming to the light, as Gemini is very much tied into communication. It is here with this North Node in Gemini to help give us the true message, the true facts, the true details, right? So the universe is here to say a lot. It is here to communicate a lot to us during this new phase that we are entering into. And so with this, a lot of old stories, a lot of old belief systems, a lot of old lies that have been swept under the rug, that have been shifted and changed around to make us see and believe it the way that those of us want us to believe it, is very much being destroyed here with the South Node in Sagittarius. Right? Sagittarius is very much dealing with knowledge just like Gemini is, but Sagittarius is about seeing the big picture, which comes with the faith, which comes with believing, which comes with seeing from a higher perspective. And so there is something big about this energy of Sagittarius, right? Nothing against Sagittarius, or for those of you who have this sign of Sagittarius, this is not against you, but as we have the South Node in Sagittarius, we are looking at the negative influences of Sagittarius, right? As the South Node is talking about karmic debt, it's talking about old stories and repeating patterns. And so we are taking a look here at this lower vibration of Sagittarius, where we're looking at these false stories and beliefs that are not the truth. And so as the North Node is in Gemini, the North Node is wanting to report back to us what is the actual truth, what are the actual facts, what are the actual details, right? As Gemini and Sag both are dealing with knowledge, but Gemini is dealing with knowledge from a smaller perspective. It is dealing with the small details, the facts, the information. And so there's a lot here that is coming into focus, that is coming into clarity here with the North Node in Gemini. And what is very interesting here too, which you will see, is that anytime you put energy into Gemini, it has the potential to change and adapt to different ways of thinking and being. And so there is this duality or this multifacetedness about Gemini as the North Node comes in here into this sign of Gemini, where we are going to see this major split in the collective, right? We're going to see people looking from multiple different lenses and views here with this North Node in Gemini. So major split that we are seeing that is coming up here as well, that has been building up to this moment. Something that we are also seeing here is that Sagittarius is dealing with long distance travel. It's dealing with foreign travels, going out, journeying far out, seeking something that is out of reach. And so with the North Node in Gemini, it is also pulling us back into what is familiar, back to the people and the places in front of us, so that we can learn to communicate more, so that we can learn to connect more, so that we can learn to face what is here in our environment, instead of going off on this long Sagittarius journey where we are escaping what is here in front of us presently in this moment, and going to seek something far off. And so it is very interesting that we are here in this lockdown as the South Node is shifting into Sagittarius, that this is very much dealing with us not putting our energy and focus out on these far off journeys and into these far off places to seek out this knowledge and connection and information, but with Gemini seeking it out in family and siblings and community in what is right in front of us. And so this North Node is pulling us back into what is familiar, back into what is safe. And we already saw that with the start of that North Node in Cancer, as Cancer very much deals with the family, with the home, of creating these deeper connections and this deeper emotional fulfillment in what is comfortable and what is safe and what is home in our hearts. And Gemini is very much connected to this, as well as Gemini is dealing with, once again, the places and people that you are familiar with, that you are around. And so in this space, if you are neglecting these connections and these peoples and places that are here in your environment in front of you, this is a very challenging placement, right? For those of you who are wanting to escape and wanting to travel far off from your home, from your environment, from the people that you are connected to, this is very difficult here. Sagittarius is dealing with freedom. It is dealing with travel. It is dealing with, once again, going off far on these expeditions for knowledge, for information, for experience. But Gemini pulls that experience into your close surrounding environments. And so there's a little bit of this restriction on freedom, on traveling, on seeking out information from faraway sources. Instead, this North Node is wanting us to come back into what is familiar, to come back into this true connection here in Gemini. And so there is a little bit of this feeling here with the South Node entering into Sagittarius of a loss of freedom, of a loss of space, of a loss of the ability to seek out in these foreign, far off lands, right? With this South Node in Sagittarius, we have done this over and over again. We've repeated this story of seeking something out that was far away, of traveling, of escaping, of running to this place of space and freedom, of running away from this connection and running away from the facts and the details and the information that is right in front of you. And instead wanting to go off on this higher journey and expedition off of this belief system and this faith that was formed without any true facts or information. And so now is the time to use your faith and your belief and your optimism to realize that now you have seen the big picture, you've seen the full story, but now it's time to fill in the little details so that you can make sense of this story, so that you can understand what is really going on in this ultimate journey, this ultimate story, this ultimate belief system that we have traveled, that we have been on here. And so there's a lot of work here that needs to be done for many of us as this North Node is entering into Gemini, where it is time to learn how to communicate with those around you. It's time to learn how to see the facts for what they truly are. It's time to learn how to interact with your familiar surroundings and your environment that you are most at home in. So this is a very difficult lesson here, and this is where the nodes are exalted, as the North Node in Gemini is here to teach us a lot. It is here to help us learn and grow through the true facts and the true information and through true communication. And the South Node in Sagittarius is here to change the story. It is here to change the belief system. It is here to change the journey. And so this is a big moment of change here with these nodes entering into this new space. And for many of you, you may have already felt this in this buildup, as these are the positions that the nodes are already in Vedic and Sidereal, right? So there is a little bit of this feeling here of this anticipation of this energy already building up and being here in this space. And so as the nodes are here at their last degrees of Cancer and Capricorn, we are in this space of now building up into this new lesson that will continue until 2022. So we're in this space here for 2 years where we need to learn how to let go of these old karmic patterns and stories by changing the belief system, changing the narrative, changing where your faith lies, changing the journey of your life, and pointing yourself towards the facts, the data, the information, the people, the connection, the true communication. And so this is your new karmic story here that is here from May 5th, 2020 through January of 2022. So let's go ahead and take a look at the chart for the North Node entering into Gemini, South Node in Sagittarius. So this is the moment that this enters in here on May 5th, 2020. And we see that the North Node is here making a sextile over to Lilith, which is sitting in Aries. And so with Lilith here, and it has been here for a very long time, right? We've seen Lilith shift through Pisces and Aries throughout this entire year. And with Lilith sitting here in Aries, it is the ultimate breakdown of the ego. It is the ultimate breakdown of the identity of what you think you are or who you believe you should be. And so as this makes the sextile over to Gemini, there is something to say about this that is big, about looking at the truth and the details and the data and the facts being part of how you figure out who you truly are and remove this mask, remove this false identity of who you think you are, of who you believe you are, and of these old wounds and attachments to who you are. And so with Lilith, it is bringing through these deeper feelings, these complications in terms of identity. And it did make that conjunction several times over with Chiron, where it does bring up wounds, it does bring up pain, trauma, right? So there's a lot here about this Lilith sitting in Aries that, once again, it is the ultimate breakdown of the ego, of how we want it to look, how we think it looks, but what is our true identity? Who are we really underneath this mask that we are wearing and presenting to others? Now, this North Node is also making a quincunx over to Pallas Athena. And I briefly spoke about Pallas Athena in very specific horoscopes, as this would be majorly affecting many of you. And so with Pallas Athena sitting in Aquarius now, brand new position, right? Pallas Athena has been back in Capricorn for a while now. With Pallas Athena entering into Aquarius now, there is something big with this Pallas Athena now making this conjunction to Saturn in Aquarius. And so now this new world order that many of us have spoke about in the astrological community here with Saturn entering into Aquarius, right? This is a new reality. As Saturn governs reality, it governs the rules, it governs the expectations, the duties, the roles, the authority. And it is now here in Aquarius where the focus is on all of the collective. It is on all of humanity, all of us as one coming together in this space. And so with all of our differences, all of our uniqueness, and all of our different qualities that we are bringing to the table, this is an ultimate space of coming into unity and taking responsibility as a whole collective, right? And if you'd like to know more about that, go ahead and take a look at the Saturn video that I made of Saturn entering in Aquarius. I will leave a link down in the description as well as the comments once this video is up. But with Pallas Athena here joining into Saturn, this is a big assist, right? And it is interesting in the astrological community, many of us do not put a heavy emphasis on these asteroids. Pallas Athena is an asteroid. And even though it is an asteroid, it is playing a huge role in this, where this Pallas Athena is all about wisdom. It's all about strategy. It's all about clarity. Finding the coping mechanism and finding the clarity and the skills to handle these stressful and difficult situations in our life. So very wise asteroid here that is here to help and assist. And very interesting that it's making this conjunction to Saturn in Aquarius, right? Where this Saturn in Aquarius feels very constrictive. It feels like it is limiting us and it is taking away from our freedom. As Saturn is the planet of rules and restrictions, and it is here in the sign of all of the collective. And so very much connected to this social distancing and very much connected to this restriction and this confinement. But there is something big also to say that Saturn is an illusion, right? Saturn is the enemy of the sun, and the sun is who we truly are. And so Saturn is ultimately a false reality, right? Saturn is an illusion, but it is the illusion that we live in. And so Saturn is dealing with this lifetime. It is dealing with this physical construct that we are living in, that we are facing, that we are dealing with. But know that underneath that you are a soul that is eternal. And so Saturn is ultimately, at the end of the day, a false reality. And Saturn is here to help us learn through this very constrictive, very difficult, challenging way where it is putting limitations and boundaries on us, forcing us to wait, forcing us to mature, forcing us to take on the difficult roles and responsibilities in society. And so Pallas Athena is here to say that the solution to all of your problems is to listen to Saturn, right? Even though we don't want to listen to Saturn, we believe that Saturn is putting us in a prison. We believe that Saturn is taking away our freedom, that Saturn is here to limit us from what we can experience. However, Pallas Athena is here to say that Saturn putting these restrictions and limitations on us as a collective is here to help us grow and learn. And that's something that we will see, especially in December of this year, when Jupiter and Saturn come together in the Great Conjunction. And this is all a part of this brand new karmic story, where we do need to learn to deal with our familiar surroundings, right? Notice that we're talking about being confined to our homes. Notice that we are talking about this order to stay in our homes, to stay inside. And Gemini is dealing with familiar surroundings. It's dealing with communication. It's dealing with short distance travel. It's dealing with connecting to those around you. And so once again, this Saturn in Aquarius is a part of this karmic story that we are in here, that we are coming into here in this North Node in Gemini. This North Node in Gemini is here to teach us to be here in what is familiar, to connect to what is familiar, to learn from what is familiar, right? A lot of our focus is outside of what is familiar, what is comfortable. And so this Pallas Athena is in agreement here that we need to come back to family. We need to come back to true connection. We need to come back to communication. We need to come back to the facts, the information, to what is familiar, and stop escaping and leaving out these important connections in our lives. Now, this is also making a semi-square over to the Sun and Mercury, which are sitting in Taurus. And so Mercury is here in Taurus, where it is a very odd spot from Mercury, right? Mercury is being forced to slow down. It's being forced to think things through step by step. It's being forced to look at what is of true value. It's being forced to take its time and slow down and be in the moment, right? Which is very uncomfortable for Mercury, as it is this very speedy mental energy that wants to think and communicate quickly. And so there's a big lesson here, once again, about this restriction of needing to be present in the moment, needing to take our times to truly connect. Keep in mind that Mercury is the ruler of Gemini, right? So with Mercury sitting here in Taurus, we need to connect and be present in the moment and think things through step by step, to take our time. And so all of us wanting to speed ahead, wanting to get things done fast, wanting this instant gratification, wanting to be free, wanting to leave behind these close connections and what is truly going on here in our environment, are being hit hard with this lesson here of needing to be present, needing to slow down, needing to have this true connection, and to connect to what is of true value and worth in our lives. And so taking the focus from outside and pulling it back in to what truly matters. So this is a huge karmic story that we are entering into, and that was your horoscope for the North Node, Rahu, and Gemini, and K2 South Node in Sagittarius. Thanks so much for watching. Once again, if you enjoyed this, feel free to leave a like as well as a comment. If you are new to this channel, don't forget to hit the subscribe button as well as the notification bell. Feel free to join the group if you have any positive or motivational advice, if you have any spiritual wisdom, any psychic messages that you would like to share, feel free to join the group Astro Metaphysical Love and Light. And I want to thank you all once again for joining. I hope you all have a great day, and I will see you in the next video.